The bullets in this episode will be played by paintballs, a technology I'm very familiar with. Now I just have to figure out a way to make them all land in the same spot, no matter where I'm aiming. Okay, I think I've come up with the right solution for the replay bullets, and it involves a piece of technology that already exists that might just be plug and play, and I'm talking to you on it. Okay, let's click to another angle. The camera gimbal, yeah! Look at how beautifully balanced it is.
This camera gimbal uses a finely calibrated system of motorized bearings that are controlled by a stabilization system designed to keep the camera shot steady regardless of the movement of the operator.
And you can put it on a setting so that once the camera's pointed in a specific direction, it's always pointed in that direction. So my theory is, if I bolt a paintball gun to this and then move it around, all the paintballs will always go to the same location. There's only one way to find out if it'll work.
This particular gimbal has been balanced and calibrated to work with the weight of this camera. But my challenge is to figure out how to mount the heavier paintball gun and get it balanced. It's a process that requires a fair amount of modification and custom parts.
All right, let's see what I can do here.
But no matter what I do, there's one problem I can't solve.
I don't see any way that this is actually gonna work.
The paintball gun's weight and its center of gravity is throwing this gimbal completely out of whack.
I think we might be 100% on this one.
The plan was always to mount the gimbal to the top of the CF1. And as I moved the gun, that gimbal would keep the barrel of the paintball gun always pointed towards the target. This is what gimbals are built to do. It seemed like a perfect marriage.
It just drops.
The biggest problem I'm having right now is that the paintball gun is so much bigger in its overall size than a camera that would go in this gimbal system, it's not able to be center balanced.
We're a little high.
Oh, we're way, way high. I mean, the first recoil will just hurl this thing.
Okay.
Paintball guns are not very modifiable. This is probably a net good for humanity, but it's kicking my butt today.
I'm just trying to think through all of my options here.
Yep. Okay, I'll go digging right now.
It'll be easy, I said.
I must admit, I'm a little disappointed here. I thought when I came up with the idea for the gimbal for our replay bullets that I had solved the problem.
But after hours of manipulating the weight distribution, I just can't get the paintball gun balanced enough to get the gimbal to work the way it's supposed to. Luckily, my colleague, and in this case, savior, John Marcoux, might have found a better option. This toy Gatling gun foam dart shooter solves all the problems presented by the paintball gun.
That's better than I seriously could have possibly hoped.
This plastic dart shooter is a fraction of the paintball gun's weight, and its smaller physical profile has put some wind back in my sails.
This is fantastic. The unit is completely contiguous and it's removable from the outer shell. The battery pack is extendable and removable from the main unit, and the trigger is electronic. Oh. Stick with me. I think this is our ammo.
I'm hoping that I've further improved our chances for success by using a more robust and more advanced gimbal.
The motors are much stronger and it can handle a bigger object. Hopefully, this is gonna work.
Dude, oh my God.
Yeah.
Dude, this is what I was envisioning. That's crazy.
As you can see, no matter which way I turn, the gun barrel remains facing forward.
Replay bullet. First bullet fires. All the subsequent bullets go exactly to the same location. Whoa, no way!
Let's face it, the concept of replay bullets that travel in sharp U-turns is pure science fantasy. And while this isn't bad, it's certainly close enough for me.
I'm a happy, happy cat.
After days of building and testing, we have all the working weapons of the fifth element's ZF1. Rocket launcher, arrow launcher, flamethrower, ice gun, net shooter, and replay bullets. Kinda. Now it's time to put it all together. Remember, it needs to be light enough and compact enough to carry and wield in battle.
This is it. This is all the parts of my ZF-1. Not quite all attached to each other, but laid out in the orientation that they will be.
By laying out all the components and everything it takes to power them, I'm starting to understand exactly how big the housing needs to be.
This is, the basic layout of the outer aesthetic covering for the ZF-1. I'm gonna cut out two of these panels and attach them to each other. They will bolt to this arrangement. It should allow me to hold everything contiguous if I can lift it all at once.
Gimbal time.
No matter how delicate the build is, at some point you're always whacking at the whole thing with a hammer, right? Picking it up. I didn't know if I'd be able to hold on to this. This is the first time I've been able to hold the whole thing with all of its attachments.
Yes, at 30 pounds, it's a whopping 25 pounds heavier than my prop replica. However, I can lift it, so I'm calling it a manageable weight.
The fact is, it's still a handheld unit. That's pretty cool.
Now that we have it physically together, it's time to give it a Zorg-style makeover.
This is so fantastic. We'll start to load up for a real test, for a real test, for a real test. Voila. Voila.
The ZF-1.
The Savage Industries ZF-2.
Slide. Handles adjustable for easy carrying. Good for riders and lefties. Strikes down on four parts, undetectable by X-ray.
It is not light and it doesn't break down into multiple components. It is good for righties or lefties, but it is detectable by a chemical swab, backscatter, and X-ray.
Six weapons, six trigger buttons. Let's get this party started.
Word on five, Tally. One shot, and replay sends every following shot to the same location.
With the Savage Industries replay button, fire the first round, and all subsequent rounds go to the same location. Yeah! You can finish them off with all the Savage Industries oldies but goodies. The rocket launcher. Oh, it's gonna blow. Damn!
Arrow launcher.
Arrow launcher.
Our famous net launcher.
Of course, our famous net launcher. Yeah!
The always efficient flamethrower.
My favorite.
All new ice cube system.
Oh,
Yeah!